Greetings, my esteemed subscribers. I have stumbled upon yet another interesting headline, this time at National Geographic. I actually used to subscribe to the magazine when I was younger. National Geographic. Good stuff. But since then, they have become a bit more heretical in certain regards, as I'm sure some of you are aware. But anyway, they produce some good content anyway, as we can see in this case. So, we have the article at hand. Mercury poisoning makes birds act homosexual. Then we have the white ibises here in the picture, who have been contaminated by mercury. So, I'm gonna read on a bit in the article before elaborating a bit myself. Male birds that eat mercury-contaminated food show surprising homosexual behavior, scientists have found. In a recent experiment in captive white ibises, many of the males exposed to the metal chose other males as mates. These male and male pairs did everything that a heterosexual pair would do, said study leader Peter Frederick, a wildlife ecologist at the University of Florida in Gainesville. Cool name, by the way, Gainesville. Hope they have good gyms there. So anyway, they continue elaborating a bit on what these birds are doing, not really necessary for our purposes today. Something that is interesting, though, is this point. Contaminated birds produce fewer babies. The article states that the metal also impacts the heterosexual couples. Overall, female birds exposed to mercury yielded 35% fewer babies than the control group. So obviously bad for both males and females. And the study goes on. I can link it below in the description box if you will, if you want to read the entire thing. But I just thought to say that I will make another video on homosexuality because I made one a few years ago which wasn't the most enlightened in its nature. So I will make another one stating my positions on the homosexuality question, but what I will say there is, to a certain extent at least, the same thing I said when I discussed the transgender question a few weeks back, and that is that a large component, if we're talking about this sort of thing, is looking at what may have caused an increase in homosexuality, for example, in humans, I mean. Has there been some environmental impact? Maybe this also works in humans, that, you know, a child exposed to a lot of mercury as a young boy will turn out to be homosexual. It's a very interesting and important thing to study, in my humble opinion. So if we're looking upon all of these sort of things, I have said it before, I'll say it again, I do believe that it has a lot to do with hormonal pollutions, all of these sort of maladies in the modern world. So transgenderism, for example, I'm absolutely certain that it has a lot to do with the body being disrupted, the hormones of the body being disrupted by environmental factors, that would the water we drink is contaminated, the fish we eat perhaps also contaminated. So this is definitely something I would like to delve deeper into. I would definitely like to see more studies being done upon these sort of things, how what you eat affects what you are, how you turn out. And it makes perfect sense. What you eat is the building blocks of your body, so make sure to eat a good diet. Now, obviously, in the modern world, you don't know what has been contaminated either. You may think that you have a very clean diet consisting of a lot of fish, but if the fish is all contaminated by mercury, yeah, it might not be good for you either. So, anyway, I will elaborate in a coming video, might be next week or something, I will elaborate on the homosexuality question. But until then, it's definitely interesting to study the effects that pollution can have on the biology and psychology of both humans and animals. So anyway, thank you for watching. XOXO, boom!